in my whole generation, my papa, papa, my papa, my papa, 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 my papa, now only me see escape poverty small. Only me for our whole generation. When I won't come clown that same me, say no, I suppose suffer. Only that me where escape, where they chop no stress. When I look, I don't deserve no stress. As my papa tell us to reach, my papa also pass Buhari, my papa also pass Obasanjo.
A few days after he was extradited to the United States from Dubai, Ramon Olorunwa Abbas, aka Hush Puppy, made his first court appearance where he was charged with accusations ranging from money laundering to participating in business email compromise BEC schemes targeting a US law firm, an English Premier League side, and a foreign bank. In a report released by the US Attorney's Office, Central District of California, Hush Puppy is accused of conspiring to launder hundreds of millions of dollars from other fraudulent schemes and computer intrusions, including one scheme to steal 100 million euro, approximately $124 million, from an English Premier League soccer club. I'm sure you did not come here for all of the information about Hush Puppy, but you came here for the comments because that was why you clicked on this video. So if you're not subscribed to this channel, you will. So welcome once again to my YouTube channel. I'm going to be saying or reading some of the comments that I currently smash on that subscribe button so that you can be a part of the family when I drop juicy content and juicy information. One of the most controversial comments that I have come across was the one that a lot of people said about Daddy Freeze. Okay, Daddy Freeze made a video 8 months ago when he did a tour of Hush Puppy's palace. Right, and so during the time they were having lunch or dinner, I think it was Hush Puppy's birthday, and then Hush Puppy made a statement that his driver earned 700,000 naira and his cleaner earned 250,000 naira. So Daddy Freeze made a statement by saying that instead of the people criticizing Hush Puppy to go and tell their fathers in the village to come and become Hush Puppy's driver, they are there criticizing Hush Puppy. So a lot of people came for him to say, okay, how on earth would you have made a statement like this? But Daddy Freeze came out to say that he, as at the time he made the statement, did not even know the source of Hush Puppy's wealth. So some people still said that if you did not know his source of his wealth, for an on-air personality and somebody who has an experience, and you see this kind of lavish life, you can tell that there's something fishy about this lifestyle, yet you still opened your mouth to say this kind of statement. Let me just insert that clip for you guys to watch so you can get what it's all about.
My salary, my driver, they collect, he almost near commission and salary. You get so I swear. They collect money past local government chairman.
That's it.
Show now they hear.
All of now they abuse. Cleaner, they collect 2.5. That is 250,000. Driver, they collect 700,000. So
instead of make you beg Hush Puppy, maybe if you use your papa to driver,
they not go green.
But not true now. Your papa dey village, you no get work.
Come think of it, that's true.
You go dey social media, they abuse
it. How much bank manager?
Collect for this salary down.
So another comment on Twitter is by most of these guys engaging in fraud are not smart. They are as dumb and as foolish as those they are scamming. How can Invictus Obi use his personal email as recovery email of the email he's using to scam? Hush Puppy's own is the worst. Same email, phone number on all accounts. So another comment was this comment by Your Daddy on Twitter. He says, in my opinion, Hush Puppy's fraud case was not a case of greed. It was a mental disorder. You have stolen 168 billion naira. At what point are you going to realize you have done too much? In the last post he made on Instagram on May success and prosperity not be a once upon a time story in your life, thank you Lord for the many blessings in my life, continue to shame those waiting for me to be shamed. That was when he just bought his latest Rolls Royce. And then Nine the Greatest 2 commented by saying, may God protect you in this hard time, and people came for him to say, oh, because you have not been swindled before by Hush Puppy, that's the reason you're passing this kind of comment. Another person said, watch out, they are coming for you too. And that person says another useless comment. So people are going on different social media to rant. So at this point, I'm going to insert some of Hush Puppy's lamentation of how he grew up as a poor boy in Nigeria.
You have to explain to me personally, why is it that my elder sister, the one I was immediately born after, had to die of just typhoid in Nigeria, in Gagada General Hospital. Why did my sister have to die? Because my parents didn't have enough money. You have to answer these questions that give me pains that I go through all the time, every day in my life. You have to be able to tell me why my parents have to suffer so much and they can't be proud of 1,000 naira. You need to arrange the debate between my papa and Buhari. May they sit down, may they talk. May Buhari need to explain to my papa where my papa got suffer so much and you know enjoy one enjoyment from the government till today. One single enjoyment my papa no dey enjoy. Buhari guys explain to my papa why my papa guys got using hand bury your own pikin. My sister die. He died throw away. If not today, you nothing say that thing do my sister. Nothing say he go die.
So a lot of comments have been flying everywhere. Some people are saying that they can now officially say that Nigerians are scammers. An average rich person in Nigeria has scammed at some point. Nigerian leaders are the biggest scammers, and that's why an average Nigerian is scamming. Nigerians are abroad and having their reputation dashed. Do you think so? Do you agree? Get a share. Let me know what you think. If you live abroad, let me know what your opinions are. Let me know how you feel, especially at your place of work. How are people looking at you? How are people relating with you now that this is happening and trending on Twitter and across social media platforms? Let me know what your opinions are. Get into the comment section. Let's talk about this. We really need to talk about this, especially as Nigerians. Do you agree with some of these statements that people have made about us as Nigerians, or do you have a different opinion? Let me know in the comment section. So do not forget that if you've watched this video to this point and you're not subscribed to this channel, you have an opportunity to do that. Please smash that subscribe button, tap on the notification bell. That way you'll get notified when I drop my next video. Until I see you in another video with juicy information, I'd like you to stay connected, be happy, stay safe, do the right thing, say no to crime, and be blessed. If you're new to my channel, click on the subscribe button, tap on the notification bell, like it, comment, and share. Thank you.